Letter to Inmate Number 271847, convicted of murder, 1985. When I heard you might get out, I was driving through the Delta, rain pounding my windshield, the sun angled and bright beneath dark clouds, familiar weather, what I'd learned long ago to call the devil beating his wife. I was listening to two things at once, an old song on the radio and, on the phone, a woman from victim services, her voice solicitous, slow, as though she were speaking to a child. I was back in the state I still call home, headed south on Highway 49, trying to resurrect my mother in the landscape of childhood as the Temptations were singing her song. The one she'd played over and over our last year in Mississippi, 1971, that summer before we moved to the city that would lead us soon to you. It was just my imagination, and I could see her again, her back to me, swaying over the ironing board, the iron steel plate catching the sun and holding it there. For a moment, I was who I had been before, the joyful daughter of my young mother, until the woman on the phone said your name, telling me I must write the parole board a letter. I was again stepdaughter, daughter of sorrow, daughter of the murdered woman. This is how the past interrupts our lives, all of it entering the same doorway, like the hole in the trunk of my neighbor's tree, at once a natural shelter, haven for small creatures, but also evidence of injury, an entrance for decay. When I saw it, I thought of how, as a child, I'd have chosen it for play, a place to crawl inside and hide. And when I thought of hiding, I could not help but think of you. What does it mean to be safe in the world? Everywhere I go, she is with me, my long dead mother. Is there nowhere I might go and not find you there too?